Hey guys, welcome to another episode of The Bow Show.
It's The Bow Show, baby!
Today I have a very special guest, defenseman number 44 for the Winnipeg Jets, and recent overtime hero, Josh Morrissey. J-Mo, thanks for coming on the show, you beauty.
Hey, thanks for having me, man.
Off the quarter board perfectly. Morrissey scores! The slap shot into the middle, takes a shot, he scores! He's coming. Another great example up top, head up by Morrissey, saw it the whole way, knew exactly where he needed to put that.
When you look at pregame rituals and you know what's going on in the dressing room before the game, who's running the aux cord? Who's getting the boys going before the game?
It kind of changes a bit. I think no matter who's running it, nobody's, you know, you can't have a consensus of happy guys, but usually it's either Wheels or Maddie Perot, and both of those guys do a pretty good job of getting us going.
And what are the boys firing up before the game? I mean, like, Wheels is a dad with, he's got, I think, two kids, right? So, I mean, like, he can't be listening to hardcore rap before the games.
You know, Wheels is a big hip-hop guy.
Big hip-hop guy.
You know, we usually start off with some hip-hop, and if Litzy's in there, he's the real dad on the team, so he'll get the rock music going, but then... Matty Perot, nicknamed Frenchie there, he usually gets the dance music going right before we go on,
and yeah,
it's pretty fun.
Speaking of Wheels, I mean, when we had him on the show, he actually mentioned you. We said, who's the coolest guy on the team? The coolest guy on the Winnipeg Jets. Who's the coolest?
Josh Morrissey. Yeah.
Young gun. Really?
He's my boy.
Yeah,
he's just a cool dude.
Yeah?
Yeah. I like J-Mo.
J-Mo. What are your thoughts on that? And I mean, what makes you so cool inside of the Winnipeg Jets locker room?
I mean, that's pretty generous. I don't know about that. You know, that's a lot to live up to. But I don't know. I'd say Wheels is pretty cool himself. He's got pretty good style. And you know, I appreciate that. It's a lot to live up to, though.
Wheels is an absolute man rocket. Like, that guy's absolute stud. So, I mean, I think you guys maybe roll together. I mean, like, the studs, like, the good-looking guys kind of hang out together.
Hey,
is that a thing?
Well, thanks for calling me good-looking, but, I guess we roll together here and there, but, Wheels is, like I said, I appreciate that comment. I'll have to thank him tomorrow.
What is one of your favorite things to do in Winnipeg?
Yeah, all sorts of things. So most of the time, we just hang out with you know, a bunch of the guys and and watch you know, football on Sundays. And our fantasy league's pretty competitive. So that's pretty much what we do. And we have a good time.
Do the boys ever play Chell? Like, do the boys ever rip Chell 19 together? Is that a thing?
I don't know if too many guys do. I mean,
Patty Laine seems to, like, on advertisements and stuff, that guy might be the biggest Chell player in the world.
Look at that ball. I don't know how that feels.
I think Patty might be the biggest gamer and might be the best gamer in the league. Him and Fly, Nicky Ehlers, they go at it pretty good. And I think they play a lot of Fortnite, but I know when Patty does play NHL, he's the guy to beat.
Yeah. So I'm currently taking the college route. I mean, all of us take different routes to show. You know, I mean, that's how it is. I chose to take the college road after leaving the Brandon Wheat Kings of the WHL. I mean, I was there, you know, I was talking to a few of the boys, you know, Nolan Patrick and, you know, my housemates over there, Pooley, you know, not to name drop, but I mean, these guys were trying to say, Bo, you gotta stay. Like, this is where you belong. You know, your speed belongs in this league. Your size, maybe not, but your speed belongs here. You know what I mean? But I said, boys, my speed belongs in college. Playing college hockey. So I took that route. Did you ever think about the college route instead of the 5-year WHL route that you took?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, as we were skating around out here before we started this interview, you could tell that you have the game, so maybe we'll see you soon. But I don't know. I for me, it was, you know, the best route for me at the time. I think everybody's different. I know that I definitely thought about it quite a lot, but it worked out for me, and it was the best route at the time.
Yeah, there couldn't be you can't really double think a route when you're making it to the bigs, eh? We're going to move to some fan questions in a second, but before we do that, I want to ask you how you charge your batteries. do you take pregame naps before games? Is that a thing for you? Like, does JMO's batteries just charge themselves during the night when you get your good eight, when you get your good 8 hours? Or do you need to recharge them with a 30-minute to an hour nap?
Yeah, I'm definitely a big pregame nap guy. Okay. I never used to be, but you know, the travel and the time zones will get you. So
tell me about it.
Really look forward to that. You know, you said half an hour to an hour. I'm more an hour, hour and a half guy. So when you get that in and you wake up, you feel pretty good. And have a Starbucks and I'm good to go.
Hey, we're going to move to three fan questions. We opened up the Bo Show Baby's Instagram for the fans to step in. Three very simple, straightforward questions. Question number one, favorite city to play in other than the Peg City?
It's always pretty cool playing at home and in Calgary. And anytime you're in the Canadian cities, I feel like there's just a little bit more of a buzz, you know, in Toronto or Montreal or some of those places. So any Canadian market's pretty fun.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought you were going to say like California playing against the Ducks, so you, you and Wheels can take your shirts off. Question number two from the fans, pregame meal.
Pregame meal kind of changes here and there, but mostly, you know, a little rice and chicken, some veggies, and maybe a little tomato sauce on top.
Hey, last question. Any roommates currently in Winnipeg?
No roommates currently. Live on my own.
Not many of the boys have roommates, eh?
Yeah, some guys do, but I think it's nice to be able to kind of go home and get your own space.
Exactly.
And then, you know, we're always hanging out with the guys the rest of the time anyways.
Yeah.
Start back with Wheeler. Wheeler slows up at center. Wheeler sends it in for Shifley. On to Morrissey. Scores! Josh Morrissey in overtime!
Hey, you scored the OT winner against Edmonton the other night after McDavid rang one right off the pipe. And you went home and you went back the other way and you said, you know what, forget about this. I got to send these fans home. Bo's got to get to work tomorrow at 8:30, so I'm going to go snipe on Talbot down there. We're going to reenact that goal, and we're going to try and get that feeling back to propel you into the new year here.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
Start back with Wheeler. Wheeler slows up at center. Wheeler sends it in for Shifley. On to Morrissey.
All right, guys, you saw it here first. JMO, low glove, exact same spot. You could pick it like it's nothing. And I was acting as Shifley on that play because that's what the boys say I play like. Josh Morrissey, defense for the Winnipeg Jets. But JMO, thanks a lot for coming on the Bo Show. And thank you guys for tuning into another episode of the Bo Show. We'll see you next time.
It's the Bo Show, baby.